Okay, so this is not a braces video, although they are coming along great. I have lost two brackets, both the same place, so I think my teeth, they may have to use a smaller bracket because my teeth just may be smaller right there, but I'll do an update soon. I'm just trying to feel, like, get the feel of them. So, yeah, there's this song that I was listening to for about, a week and a half, and I'm gonna play it real quick, not the whole thing, just giving you an idea. It's called Take Me to Church by, I don't know how you pronounce the name, by, like, Hozier or something, or, I'm not even sure. My lover's got humor, she's a giggle at a funeral, knows everybody's disapproval, I should've worshipped her sooner. If the heavens ever did speak, she's the last true mouthpiece. Every Sunday's getting more bleak, fresh poison each week. We were born sick, you heard them say it. My church offers no absolutes. She tells me worship in the bedroom, and only heaven I'll be sent to. Okay, so now that you just get a quick feel of the song, it's a more slow song, like Hallelujah, stuff like that. So at first I was, because the wording he uses, you know, like, my lover's got humor, she's the giggle at her funeral, whatever, I don't even know anymore. Like, she tells me worship, stuff like that. I did not see anything wrong with this song, and obviously I was wrong. You know, I was wrong because, I actually sat here and cried for about 10 minutes when I was looking up for the cover, the karaoke version. And, because I really like this song, you know. Maybe I'm clueless because there are, like, now that I know, I can see a ton of hints that were dropped, like, you know, we were born sick, should have just figured. I was thinking something else, like, they're both kind of crazy and they found each other, such like, you know, the Fault in Our Stars, they're not crazy, but I'm saying they both have a sickness, so they both bonded, like, crazy well, and I was thinking of something like that, like, that we're both kind of insane, and, it really, like, didn't make much sense. I just kind of like the tune and stuff. Anyway, I was looking for the karaoke version, and the video popped up, and I was kind of like, oh, okay, you know, I'll watch this, and that was a very, very bad idea, but also, I'm happy I know. So, we're gonna see if I can get you to see this video. Now, if you watched any of my other videos, you'll know that I'm a very proud conservative. I don't believe in any of the liberals stuff, crap, like that. But anyway, we're going to start this video up at the start again, and we're going to make it big so you can see. And you're going to see why this pisses me off. My lover's got humor. She's a giggle at a funeral, knows everybody's disapproval. I should've worshipped her sooner. If the heavens ever did speak, she's the last true mouthpiece. Every Sunday's getting more bleak, fresh poison each week. We were born sick, you heard them say it. My church offers no absolutes. She tells me worship in the bedroom. Sent to is when I'm alone with you. I was born sick, but I love it. Command me to be well. Amen. 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 Take me to church. I worship like a dog at the shrine of your light. Okay, so I can't even watch anymore. You kind of get the gif. Born sick, born gay. First of all, you're not born gay because, abortion's okay because you're never technically alive until you're actually born. So obviously they cannot develop feelings then if they're, not alive until born. Which pretty much means you're hypocrites, if you think that. Second of all, a person does not start getting feelings for anything until the age of at least 10. That's when you, at least 10 or something, like 10 through 12 or something, is when you start developing, whatever it's called. Connection. Whatever. Okay? You don't start liking anyone, clinically proven, until you start kind of like 10-ish, stuff like that, until you get into your older years. I mean, we all know, like, when we were younger and we used to say, oh, they have cuties. Stuff like that. That's just how it is, okay? So, pretty much, the whole born gay thing is ridiculous. Now, I can say what I possibly may think is that over time, different things that happen in your life can, in a sense, without you knowing, lead you to like the same gender, but you're never born gay, okay? First of all, let's just get that out of the way. When you are 8 months old, you're not like, oh, I like boys. I love boys. Oh my gosh, they're so hot, okay? And then boys aren't like, oh, girls. So attractive. So wonderful. If we don't even do that, we're not going to be doing it towards the same gender. Because when we grow up, okay, I can't really say this anymore because in the schools that everyone goes to, it's pretty much painted on the walls that gay is okay and stuff like that. Bull crap like that. First of all, it is never okay to be gay. Okay, another thing too is you cannot be Christian and support gays. It just does not work like that. It has never worked like that. It will never work like that. Just saying. Okay. I'm sick, okay? It never works like that, okay? He says at least 10 times, I believe, that homosexuality is a sin. That not even a sin, it's an abomination, he says. It's hypocritical to the max to be a Christian and believe in God but also think it's okay to be gay. Just saying. Also, okay, you, like I said before, do not start liking anyone or anything. You don't really start liking anyone, okay, until, like, the age of, like, 10, okay? Yeah, you may like a girl, whatever, okay? You may be a guy and you may like a girl at a younger age, but you never actually move forward, well, at least in my day, you never actually moved forward with that until you were a little older, like, at least in high school. Okay, you didn't just go off and at the age of 7 go and like, oh, you want to go out? That just did not happen, okay? It is ridiculous, okay? Liberals are such hypocrites, seriously. Okay, so abortion, again, is not bad because a baby is not alive. It doesn't have, thoughts. It doesn't have any of that, stuff like that. Until at least, until they're born. The baby is not there. It's not alive until it's born. Okay? First of all, that's false. Oh, you guys say the only thing that is for certain in the womb is what gender you are. So how on earth could you be born gay? Just a question. Also, okay. Oh, I've said this a billion times, but I honestly just cannot. It's ridiculous. Toby, it's okay. Settle down. Okay. Seriously, though, it's literally the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard in my life. Toby, do you want the camera on you? Hey, Toby. Come here. Okay. So point being, it just does not work like that. Never has, never will. Now, I am going to real quick show you something that you may find pretty interesting. Sorry. I'm not looking at the screen right now because I'm getting something. Okay. Alrighty. Let me find the account on Instagram. Okay. So first thing, all I'm going to say first of all is that it is absolutely, absolutely, absolutely ridiculous liberal logic. Okay. I actually think there is an account called Liberal Logic because it's so ridiculous. Now, okay. Got it. Got it. Got it. Okay. Found the page. Finally. Okay. So this page is a friend of mine who we happened to get the braces on the same day. Twinning. Anyway. Sorry. Okay. So pretty much, okay. So someone on this account said this. Okay, when my friend on her conservative stand, whatever, account said that abortion is murder, this one girl came on, no one is killed if it is unborn because no one is alive when they are unborn, is word by word, it is not alive yet to die. It does not feel the abortion because, again, it is not alive yet to die. It does not have a working brain. It does not have a working mind. Word by word, that is what she said. Okay. Now I'm going to read this little thing on abortion. Okay. Okay. Watch part 2.